we're going to talk about how to color match in Premiere Pro. What is color matching in Premiere Pro used for? One of the common ways is matching video clips between two different cameras, but you can also use this to create your own look. This can save you time. If you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications and you won't miss any of my tutorials. I'm going to create my own look. To do that, I used a snapshot from the video clip as my reference for my color matching. A reference can be a still or another video clip. From my video clip, I chose a frame and I'm using export frame right here at the bottom of the program window. And I saved that to my hard drive and I opened it into Photoshop. Now you can use any photo or any still and do the same thing. So what I did is I added a color lookup adjustment layer, and in the properties of the color lookup, I chose edgy amber. Now I'll enable this and this is what it looks like. And then I exported my still from Photoshop and then I added it to my project here in Premiere Pro. Now my timeline, here's my source clip with the edgy amber applied to it from Photoshop. And here is the clip. And this is how the clip looks before we apply the color match. So we're gonna work with the Lumetri color panel. My Lumetri color panel is up here on the right. And if you don't see Lumetri color, you can come to window and check Lumetri color. Here in Lumetri color, there's something called color wheels and match. And right here is the comparison view. Click on comparison view. Now I like to work on it where my reference is on the left and the current clip or the shot that you want to transfer the color to is on the right. And here in your comparison view, you have some controls for navigation. What I'm currently on is side by side, and then you can click vertical split and you can change the split if you want to see the comparison differently. And you also have horizontal split, and you can also change the view of that split in that window. I like to use the side-by-side comparison. Here on the far right, you have these two arrows and you can swap the sides of the two clips. I can click on that and now the reference is on the right and the current is on the left. Any way you choose to work. Over here in the color match window, you have this slider right here, and that's basically your timeline. You can see I'm moving it and it's moved past my reference clip and it is going on to the current clip. I would start all the way over to the left. If I hit this arrow, it's going to go to each edit in your timeline, depending on how many you have. And this, you can actually change your reference point on your timeline by scrubbing on this timestamp. So again, I'd have the slider all the way to the left. And this icon here is just for a shot or frame comparison. Now, all you have to do is press apply match. Now, as I do that, notice the color wheels. The color wheels are going to change. Here's apply match. Color wheels have changed. And with any one button auto correction, it gets you to a point where you may need to make some kind of adjustments. So you would use these color wheels to make a few adjustments to get it exactly to where you like. So you can click, for instance, on the midtones on this plus right here, hold the shift down, and your changes will happen a lot faster. You need to make more orange or more yellow. You can change your midtone slider and try and get it to where you like it and as close as possible to a match. In this case, if you have faces in your shot, you may want to check face detection. This is going to help protect skin tones. And you can make a couple of minor adjustments in the basic panel, but this is a good way to create your own look and save yourself some time using Color Match in Premiere Pro. If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.